Hi, I'm Dee Brooks with the Jeder Institute, and I'm going to talk about asset mapping. Asset mapping is something that we truly believe mobilizes communities, and there's three different elements of that. There's identify and connect and creating opportunities. When you're identifying assets, there's six assets of ABCD that you can look at. Within those six assets and identifying those, when you are connecting them and finding like-minded people or supporting organizations to link up with community groups or looking at stories and history of a community, whatever the assets are that you identify, then connecting them with people, the most important part is creating the opportunities for the assets to be productive and powerful together. When people identify their assets, quite often they will connect people up, but they will forget that we also have an important role as community development workers, and that is to create the space. So it's not doing for communities, it's opening up that space where those assets, once connected, can be really powerful and effective. So how we do this is multiple different ways, and there's different elements of asset mapping that we look at Jeder anyway. So within that elements of asset mapping, you can shift from the external, like the environmental or bioregionalism. You can map that, map systems, map organizations. And when we do mapping of organizations, it's really important to think about, it's not what organizations can go out and do to community. It's actually what are the assets that organizations have that they can offer community so they can be supported to do something more creative and productive. So then from the organizations, we can look at community mapping, and that's where we look at the six assets of ABCD. Then from community mapping, we look at the individual. What are the individual talents, gifts, skills, and passions? An example of that was when I was working in Indonesia. I'm working with the childcare services around reform there at the moment. And so we looked at that system from externally, right down into the individual. Once those individual assets had been identified and connected, then we looked back out through the system. So where those individual assets can be productive and powerful out through the community, to organizations, to the system, to the region. It's something that is a ongoing dialogue. And I think, as I said, our job, it's really important that we create that space where people can feel that they have ownership, that they can step up to practice, and that they feel that they can really offer what they care about enough to act on and something that they're really, really passionate about. I have worked with many organizations around the world, and I'll find a lot of the time people will do the identification and the connection, and quite often it stops there. So my most important message from this is that third step. How can we create opportunities for those assets to be productive and powerful together?